I am a realist. I will always have hope, but you do have to have this balance between being realistic and being hopeful. And that's why when people say never lose hope, well, it's tough. I'm going and seeing my oncologist almost every day at some points, and she's giving me not so much the stats, we don't talk in stats, but prognosis, my specific prognosis, knowing that the odds of me seeing 40 years old is like 1%. I am somebody who will hold on to that 1%, but it is tough to balance what's realistic, hope, and fear, because fear is something that will, it's a motivator, but it can also just destroy you. And if you focus so much, I think what I've realized is that for me, recognizing it and understanding it and facing that this is the my life or my it's the R word, realism? No, my reality. For me, knowing that this is my reality and coming to terms with that has helped a lot with the fear. Instead of being afraid of what I'm trying to deal with or what I'm trying to face, knowing, like, knowledge is power, right? So knowing what I'm about to face and dealing with all those hard end-of-life conversations and advanced planning has really helped me with fear. Okay, now I don't have to worry about end-of-life decisions. They're made now. Now I can continue living. So I find that the more I kind of face it head-on and the more I talk about it and the more I'm honest and real, fear kind of plays less of a role in my life with cancer.